So now we're gonna be taking a look at some videos, and I'm gonna tell you some stories from behind the scenes that hopefully you haven't heard before. So I hope you enjoy them. Take a look. So the I Knew You Were Trouble music video was, it was a long shoot. It was out in the desert. It was like very, very in character stuff. And you put so much work into a music video and then you have no idea what the internet is gonna do with it. Like, I'm pretty sure that the most people who saw this music video saw it in a viral clip of like a goat screaming, which came out shortly after the video. And it's fine. It's like, I was like, This is a viral video. This just happened. I had no idea how, but it ended up being one of the most hilarious turn of events, because it's like you just have no idea where things are gonna come from out of left field, including like, you know, screaming goats. I knew you were trouble when you walked in. It's good. That's why people watch it so many times. I think when it's all over, it just comes back in flashes, you know? It's like a kaleidoscope of memories. It just all comes back. But he never does. I think part of me knew the second I saw him that this would happen. It's not really anything he said or anything he did. It was the feeling that came along with it. And crazy thing is, I don't know if I'm ever gonna feel that way again. But I don't know if I should. I knew his world moved too fast and burned too bright. But I just thought, how can the devil be pulling you towards someone who looks so much like an angel when he smiles at you? Maybe he knew that when he saw me. I guess I just lost my balance. I think that the worst part of it all wasn't losing him. It was losing me. Once upon a time, a few mistakes ago, I was in your sights. You got me alone. You found me. You found me. You found me. I guess you didn't care, and I guess I liked that. And when I fell hard, you took a step back. Without me. Without me. Without me.
Doesn't know that he's the reason why you're drowning, you're drowning. loved me or her or anyone or anything. If you know who you are until you lose who you are.
Cause I knew you were trouble when you walked in. So shame on me now, blew me to places I've never been. Till you put me down.
For the last 2 days, we've been shooting the video for I Knew You Were Trouble, which is the new single off of my album Red. We've been all over the place, just kind of building the story of these two people who have this really epic, really toxic relationship. This video is edgy because the narrative of it is edgy. The song sounds different than anything else I've ever done before, so I thought, why not make this video unlike anything we've done before? We knew we wanted it to be some sort of corruption. You know, good girl runs into this force. This guy is just like a force. She'll do anything to fit into his world, including change everything about herself.
I feel great. I'm so excited about this.
I've never worked with Anthony Mandler before, and he is blowing me away. The way he works is so natural, it's so daring and exciting, and he gets an idea and then you shoot it. I feel like he's gonna make sort of a mini movie out of this.
An innocent love affair starts innocent and maybe turns a little less innocent. Or as Taylor would say, sometimes you know something's not right from the beginning, but the attraction's so strong that you can't help but see what happens. And so we're trying to tell that story.
I knew that in this video I wanted to look like someone else. I wanted to play a character, I wanted to be an acting piece. I wanted the guy to have this unmistakable, one-of-a-kind look. And so that's when I thought of Reeve Carney.
Oh my God, thank you for doing this. This is so cool.
My name is Reeve Carney. I'm here playing Taylor Swift's boyfriend, her rebellious, dangerous guy who likes to start fights with guys way bigger than he is.
What's interesting about what we've shot is that we've shot so many adorable, beginning, spontaneous, lovely scenes of these two falling in love. And that interspersed with the aftermath is what I think is gonna really make this story well-rounded.
I knew you were trouble when you walked in. Trouble, trouble, trouble. Cause I knew you were trouble when you walked in.
I just came from the AMAs, I did a performance, we won an award, and now we're gonna shoot a video all night. We've been working on the concept for this video for a few months now. This girl is going about her life, hanging out with her friends, and all of a sudden this dude pulls up in her town, they fall in love really fast. He lives a really dangerous, exciting life that she finds out later is actually really dark.
We shot an incredible fight scene. What's really cool is it comes right after a really innocent, honest moment between the two of them, kind of in this dirty bar in the middle of nowhere. And you really feel their connection. You feel this kind of like pull between them.
We're having the most amazing, romantic, sweet night, and we're dancing, you know, on the booth as soon as we walk out. And Reeve's character just randomly picks a fight with these guys playing pool. just because he's destructive.
Reeve is gonna beat up some guys, or let some guys beat up him, or let them think they're beating up on him, but he still ends up with the girl. So who really is the winner here? Thing to remember that's important here is Reeve doesn't have a stunt double. He's actually gonna do this.
The next scene was shot in the bathroom of the bar, and it's a scene of me singing the song, narrating, kind of realizing that maybe this is bad. Apologies, he'll never see you cry. There's paparazzi all across the street, so I am traveling like this. The next scene we shot was out on a balcony.
We are on our lover's ledge, staring at the stars.
We're on a balcony, looking at stars that aren't there.
Yeah, I guess the pink hair is my fault, but it does look good on you, actually.
Thank you.
I really wanted to do something different with my look for this video, like my hair especially, because I wanted to be as in character as possible. My character has like dyed her hair pink because she's trying to fit in with this like fast-moving dude, and he's corrupting her in almost every way, including her look. We switched locations and we went to this horrendous warehouse that smelled like dead bodies, and it was horrible and scary.
We shot a kind of underground goth metal fight club scene, which is, I guess, where he thought it was a good idea to take this really cool girl to.
Yes, I'm gonna be in the middle of a mosh pit, which is, this will be a first for me. I've never been involved in this type of activity before.
So you're looking forward to it?
Yeah, I'm just gonna be a little careful, you know, make sure to like, protect the teeth.
That scene signified where Reeve's character takes my character to this place she doesn't fit in, and he knew she wouldn't fit in, and he didn't care.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's give a round of applause to Taylor Swift for a great day, please.
Shoot is over, and I cannot wait to see how that scene turned out, but I'm gonna go to sleep. It's 2 a.m. This place is really weird.
It's 3 a.m. actually.
It's 3 a.m. actually. This is really late, and I have a like really early call time tomorrow for the rest of the video, so I'll see you later. And this place is creepy. Try not to get killed on the way out. Today was when we were out in the middle of the desert, in the middle of nowhere in California. None of us have phone service. But other than that, it's gorgeous and scenic and beautiful out here, and it's the perfect place to shoot a tragic love story.
We're like 12 miles off of the 14 freeway in Acton, California. It's my first time here. I can't tell if this was ever an actual town or if it's a complete facade, but it's very cool.
You know, if I can get that nice close-up of your point, your eyes meeting, that kind of thing that happens.
Taylor's a sweetheart, such a humble girl, or young woman, I should say, but for especially all the success she's had, she handles herself very well, so it's a pleasure to work with her.
The character that Reeve is playing is not stereotypical because he's not all bad. He's sweet and kind and sensitive, and everything that this girl wants sometimes.
We're trying to tell that story. Create innocent moments, create honest moments, but then combat those with moments that are maybe darker or inappropriate or not what she expected from this guy. So the veil starts to fall as time goes on.
I think it's fun playing sort of a bad guy, especially in a music video, because you don't have to do it for very long. So that's kind of a good thing. But it's definitely a little bit of a stretch for me, but it's fun. I like how Anthony described it, sort of being a glutton for pain in some weird way, you know, wanting to, just doing things that clearly are not good for you, but somehow, I don't know, it just draws some people in.
I reached out to Anthony because I had loved his videos that he'd done in the past. I just thought they were insane. He knows how to push limits, and we just had to decide which ones we were gonna push. insane. I'd never done anything like this.
We wrote a whole book and really painted a beautiful story, and now it's about assembling that story into something that people can connect with and learn from and grow from. I think we took a lot of chances. I think we pushed the Taylor Swift world into a place that maybe nobody's seen her, and I think she pushed herself, and that's it.
I don't think I would have written this type of narrative a couple years ago, because I hadn't realized yet that getting my heart broken isn't only one person's fault. I guess that's where I am now in my life. If I realized early on that this was a huge risk factor and I went for it anyway, it's my fault too. Who is getting text messages? Out here?
Yeah, exactly. That's what I was thinking.
I am so jealous.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's give a big round of applause to Taylor Swift for two great days. Let's not forget our amazing director, Anthony Mandler, and the crew. Thank you very much, folks. That's a wrap. Knew you were trouble when you walked in. Trouble, trouble, trouble.
We shot the Begin Again music video in Paris, which is one of the most beautiful places I've ever been. And I remember when I was shooting this scene in a bakery, like a pastry case was in front of me, and I was just like staring at them so hard that the prop department people were like, you want those, don't you? And I was like, yes, I do. But I don't think they expected me to eat like everything that was in the pastry case. I just remember just like eating these pastries like it was my job, like it was my one duty on this earth, was just to make sure they were gone before the end of the day. And they were.
Took a deep breath in the mirror. He didn't like it when I wore high heels, but I do. Turned the lock and put my headphones on. He always said he didn't get this song, but I do. Expecting you'd be late, but you got here early and you stand and wave. I walk to you. You pull my chair out and help me in, and you don't know how nice that is, but I do. And you throw your head back laughing like a little kid.
Thank you.
we're in London. It is it's earlier than I care to really even say. We're starting to shoot the video for I Don't Wanna Live Forever. And I'm first, because clearly, I don't demand late enough call times, because Zane's asleep. Somewhere in London, I imagine, under some kind of silk duvet. I don't wanna live forever, 'cause I know I've been living in vain. I mean, did you catch that? Did you see that last take, what I did there? The way that I was able to emote with the back of my head? See, that's what 12 years of experience gets you. Till you come back home. What we're doing right now is a glitter lip that I've seen on, like, you know, in shoots and on the runway and stuff, but I haven't really seen people do it in a music video or anything, so.
That looks so good. Yeah. Guys, I'm so excited. This is so cool. I just wanna keep calling your
name. I'm just, like, really stoked about the lips right now.
The lips look
I feel
sick.
Like I have a disco ball on my face. Coming up, you're gonna see the Blank Space music video, one of my favorite things I've ever done, one of the most hilarious shoots that I've ever been on. And we were actually on set at this beautiful, beautiful location called the Woolworth Mansion. And regarding some of the things that may or may not have gotten damaged during or after the shoot, might be surprising to know that there actually was no damage to the car at the end of the video. A lot of CGI took place. I was actually hitting it with a golf club that didn't have the end on it, and Joseph Kahn, the director, is so incredibly talented with visual effects that he actually added the dents and stuff. So a lot of people, when they would watch this video, they'd be like, oh no, the car, no! But the car is fine. Actually, the mansion isn't though, because it had a fire right after we left, but I had nothing to do with that. So enjoy the video.
Dressed like a daydream.
So it's gonna be forever.
Love.
Boys only want love if it's torture. Don't say I didn't, say I didn't warn ya. Boys only want love if it's torture. Don't say I didn't, say I didn't warn ya. So it's gonna be forever. Your name.
Behind the app is that it's an interactive version of the music video. So the storyline that we follow in the music video will be following again within the interactive experience. You'll be able to move from room to room whenever you want to. You'll be able to follow Taylor and Sean as they go on their linear story, but you'll also be able to jump into a room when they're not there or at any time. Essentially, for a fan, it's a way of stepping inside of the house, stepping inside of the music video, and being given completely free range to discover the story the way that you want to.
I'm gonna put your napkin on your lap and kind of be like, you know, have a nice meal. I'm gonna slowly walk around the table, pick up my drink, and cheers to you. You take a drink, and then when you look up, I'm leaving, and you gotta
jet, because as soon as she's out the door, you're gonna be out the door with her.
And role play back.
It has to be completely perfect, because really, as the viewer, you're standing in the middle of the room. You can look anywhere, so we can't have anyone else in the room. We can't have any equipment showing in the room, so you get a completely pure experience, so that you really feel like you're just a person walking around a house. You can get completely lost inside of a story and completely forget the fact that you're actually standing from the camera's perspective.
Maybe it's like it says Sean, but then underneath it you can see like Roy. You know, like it kind of like you can see that you wrote other names underneath it, you know?
So cool.
Obviously, we'll add the rest of the CG, you know? Bam! Bam! Scream! Keep going. That girl is insane.
We
with American Express, we've been able to create something that I've never been able to give my fans before, which is a 360-degree interactive experience where they're getting to explore the storyland of our video and be in the room with us. This video experience is really fun because we can hide things in the rooms for fans to look at and to see. And I think that us coming together and figuring this out as kind of like a gift for the fans, like, thank you for being so amazing. Here's an in-depth look at what we've been doing. And we did all of this for them. You know, it's extra shooting, it's extra setups, it's this amazing 360 technology. And hopefully the fans will like it and have fun with it, because it's been really hilarious to make. So the song Blank Space is a song that I wrote a little bit from sort of a comedic perspective. I try to stay pretty self-aware about, you know, who I actually am, and also pretty aware of what the media's depiction of me is. And so I've seen all the different, you know, rumors that have come and gone, and it's kind of developed over the years. It's developed into this reputation for being somewhat of a crazy serial dater, needy, clingy, manipulative person. And so I was thinking a lot about that. I was thinking about that reputation, and I just thought, you know what, like, what if I was that girl? What song would I write? So I wrote Blank Space. Joseph Kahn is one of my favorite directors because his videos are so creative, and you always see him using his creative mind to make the artist go out of their comfort zone. So I sent him all these reference shots of photos that I had seen of mansions and people in love in mansions. And then I sent pictures of, like, kind of crazy psychotic girlfriends and, like, crying and mascara and tantrums, and walked him through what I thought would be a cool idea. And his ideas that he came up with just amped it up even more. And what we ended up with is this video about this girl who basically gives you the best first part of a relationship. And then all of a sudden you realize there's just one problem. She's absolutely psychotic. So that's what the video's about.